Every year, Halloween Horror Night speculation maps circulate online, and this year was no exception. Upon this map surfaced a rumour that provoked shock and even outrage from some fans. Music superstar, The Weeknd, was rumoured to have his own house. No way was this pop singer going to be at Halloween Horror Nights. To that I say, you don't know The Weeknd. So please, let me enlighten you on why he is just perfect for the event. Although never officially announced for the cancelled Halloween Horror Nights event in 2020, it was heavily rumoured that the singer Billie Eilish would receive a house. Lots of Eilish's videos featured horror imagery, but compared to The Weeknd, hers is child's play. No, not the film with the killer doll. What I mean is that it's not that present or that dark compared to The Weeknd's. This rumour was pretty much confirmed when images of props built for the house surfaced online. When Halloween Horror Nights requested again to actually do the house in 2021, her team reportedly said no. For anyone who's followed her career, this makes sense as her current image has completely strayed away from anything horror related. Unlike Billie Eilish, The Weeknd's relationship with the horror genre goes deep. He's a huge cinephile and seems to favour the horror genre. During practically every part of his career, references have been present. For most people, when they think of horror and music, it's rock and heavy metal that comes to mind, or classical music to score a ghostly tale. Neither of these are surprising first thoughts, but pop music, especially the synthy 80s sound of much of The Weeknd's recent music, has its place within the horror genre. The 80s synth sound can obviously, at first listen, be associated with the likes of John Carpenter, or more recently, Kyle Dixon and Michael Stein. Music like this was played throughout Halloween Horror Nights 28 to match its 80s theme, and went down a treat. Pop music itself has long earned its place within the horror genre. Just think of the iconic Huey Lewis in the News, Hip to Be Square, in Mary Harron's American Psycho, or the more recent use of the Beach Boys' Good Vibrations during an unsettling scene in Jordan Peele's Us. Pop music can be horrific, and I don't just mean some of the atrocious top 40 stuff, I mean truly terrifying. Oh, and how can we talk about horror, pop music, and The Weeknd without bringing up Michael Jackson's Thriller? Horror visuals juxtaposed with upbeat music can be wonderfully effective. Bands and artists such as Rob Zombie, Black Sabbath, Slash, and Alice Cooper never received the same questions when they appeared at Halloween Horror Nights. And hey, maybe that's fair enough. There's not much to look at within the images and careers of these artists that doesn't exude horror. Perhaps fans of Halloween Horror Nights only listen to rock and metal, but I've been to the event enough times and can see that this isn't true. I'm not judging music tastes on appearance. I'm judging it on the t-shirts I've seen at the event. Halloween Horror Nights is an incredibly popular event with diverse fans. From an early age, Abel Tesfaye, to use The Weeknd's real name, became obsessed with dark, psychologically disturbing films. Before he ever wrote songs, he reportedly wrote scripts inspired by these films and actually still claims that's what he'd most like to be doing. He got his start writing scripts inspired by films about seduction, drug abuse, secrets and paranoia. Themes that he has not abandoned, but simply taken with him into his songwriting. His lyrics have always been full of these dark themes. As a result of being camera shy, he even remained anonymous for the early part of his career. And of this, he has said that, "No one could find pictures of me. It reminded me of some villain." A rather fun article from the website DJ Booth, titled "The Weeknd is a Vampire, Seriously?" confirmed a thought I've had for a while. Not that The Weeknd is actually a vampire, but that his work exudes a similar feeling to much vampire content. In this article, the author points out the frequent focus of the singer's lyrics on seduction, drug consumption, and nightlife. making his lifestyle survival and the suggested numbers of women reminiscent of the immortality and hypnosis of vampires. The Weeknd's thirst for these things appears unquenchable, and it appears to have been this that has led him, or at least the character he presents in his music, into the underworld of the disturbing films he has long enjoyed. The author decides that if Abel is a vampire, he would best fit in the 1987 movie The Lost Boys. Of course, or at least as far as I know, The Weeknd isn't actually a vampire, but the naive eternal youth attitude reflected in many of his songs is reminiscent of immortality. His thirst for drugs and women is reminiscent of the bloodlust and actual lust of many vampire portrayals. Right from the start, both his image and his words have been pretty dark, but dark doesn't always equal horror. It was mostly within his music videos that this horrific tendency began to clearly display itself. When it comes to building a Halloween Horror Nights house, drawing upon the subjects and references within an artist's music is not usually the key element inspiring the design. Instead, the creative team has typically opted to draw from an artist's visual catalogue in order to create this largely visual experience. So without further ado, let's explore some of The Weeknd's music videos. Following the release of three mixtapes in 2011, The Weeknd released his first album, a compilation of these three projects, aptly titled Trilogy, in 2012. During these early years, preceding the release of any music videos, signs of The Weeknd's tendency to reflect the horror genre were already there. Although nothing more than a quick name drop, in his song House of Balloons Glass Tables, he sings, "And we could turn this to a nightmare Elm Street," a reference of course to Wes Craven's A Nightmare on Elm Street. Even his songs, The Birds Part 1 and The Birds Part 2, have been assumed, understandably, to reference Hitchcock's The Birds, due to their shared title and subject of a fatal doomed love story. Following on from this, it was in his music videos that we first really began to see the signs that The Weeknd would experiment with horror imagery throughout his career. In his second ever music video for his song Wicked Games, released in October 2012, there are tons of horror references to spot. It is suggested by fans that the trench coat the woman in the video wears is supposed to be reminiscent of Tippi Hedren's jacket in Alfred Hitchcock's The Birds. You could argue that this is a bit of a reach, but with songs titled The Birds and a career full of nods to the horror genre, it's not so easy to dismiss. A harder to ignore reference can be found in the hairstyle of the woman, which is styled after Gary Oldman's version of Dracula in Francis Ford Coppola's film Bram Stoker's Dracula. Chiaroscuro lighting is utilised to create harsh shadows, a technique derived from German Expressionism, a movement which produced horror films such as The Cabinet of Dr. Caligari and Nosferatu. The latter of these films is directly referenced through the shadows within the video. Some even suggest that the headlights evoke John Carpenter's Christine. His music video for The Zone features giant bloodshot eyes and a dark strobe-lit room of popping balloons, both pretty horrific scenes. The first overtly horror music video The Weeknd released was for the song 28. The video opens with a shot of a dark empty hallway, a frequent motif in horror films such as Halloween, Suspiria, and of course, The Shining. Next, The Weeknd can be seen in an interview setup similar to a scene in David Cronenberg's Videodrome, a body horror film. Within the video, a ghost woman watches the interview on a TV in an empty bedroom. This image of a ghost and a TV makes it hard not to think of films like Poltergeist and The Ring. It seems she is someone from his past, haunting him and distracting him from the success he should be enjoying, as he returns in the end to her. Using a ghost to symbolise an inescapable traumatic past is familiar to the horror genre, and I believe we can directly compare this music video to ghost stories such as The Haunting of Hill House, which was present at Halloween Horror Nights last year. His second album, Kissland, is, at least for me, the album that really cemented The Weeknd within the world of horror. Of this album, he has said that a lot of it is inspired by filmmakers like John Carpenter, David Cronenberg, and Ridley Scott, because they know how to capture fear. That's what Kissland is to me, an environment that's just honest fear. So when you hear the screams in the record and you hear all these horror references and you feel scared, listen to the music, because I want you to feel what I'm feeling. Kissland is like a horror movie. However, such themes are not what you expect from an album titled Kissland. The Weeknd himself has called this title ridiculous and wanted it to be so to juxtapose the dark, twisted world within the songs. Kissland is the idealized world of fame, but the actual substance of the album is the terrifying, all-consuming world of fame. For his next album, The Weeknd tried something new, which we have since seen reoccur multiple times within his videos. All of the music videos for The Weeknd's next album, Beauty Behind the Madness, are narratively connected. Throughout this horror-filled series of music videos, he features the devil who lights him on fire, buries his own singing corpse, and commits murder. The Weeknd's video trilogy tells the timeless Faustian tale where success comes at a great spiritual price. It's also pretty apt that he heavily references Wes Craven's film The Hills Have Eyes in his song The Hills. Within the music videos for his 2016 album Starboy, the horror references got more and more overt. In the first video for the song Starboy, The Weeknd is tied to a chair and suffocated by another version of himself. The next song to receive a music video was False Alarm. This controversial video utilized a first-person perspective and showcased a violent bank heist gone wrong through the perspective of the gunman. As an added horror nod, some of the crooks sport silver shamrock-esque skull masks. This video has often been compared to a first-person shooter video game and is extremely violent. At the end, we learn just before he shoots himself that the perspective we had been watching from was The Weeknd's. This leaves the only living person the female hostage, making her a final girl worthy of joining the likes of Laurie Strode, Sydney Prescott, and Nancy Thompson. Another violent video for the song Mania features The Weeknd as a panther who viciously lashes out against an antagonizing man in the bathroom of a club. Afterwards, The Weeknd shares a chilling dance with a love interest while still covered in the blood of his recent prey. It is a scene worthy of any vampire tale. The video for Party Monster has a distorted VHS style to show The Weeknd descending into a hellish trip, where extreme colour usage and psychedelic lighting turn a party into a disorientating nightmare. The flashes of blood, glowing-eyed women, and a menacing panther make the video live up to its title. In I Feel It Coming, The Weeknd goes full Medusa in a storyline where a woman he dances with suddenly turns to stone after an eclipse. In the video's haunting final moments, The Weeknd too turns to stone and cracks apart on the ground. His video for Secrets is set in a hotel with blood-red carpets, tight hallways, and numerous elevators, causing many fans to compare it to Stanley Kubrick's The Shining. This year, for the 5th anniversary of his album, Starboy, The Weeknd released a music video for Die For You. This video is set in an E.T. Stranger Things-like world and features a younger version of The Weeknd trying to escape from an ominous science lab. At the end of the video, the young The Weeknd is beamed up, presumably returning home, providing an explanation for his supernatural powers. Only one video release for his 2018 album, My Dear Melancholy, featured horror-like imagery. In the Call Out My Name music video, The Weeknd parades around a vacant street, singing before vomiting out flying bats. Later, The Weeknd is tempted by an animal-woman hybrid, eerily sitting on a hillside. The video ends with a creepy zoom onto this character, now standing on a balcony. The Weeknd's next album, After Hours, again featured a series of music videos which are all linked. He has stated that all these videos are taking place in one night. We have this guy go through a complete breakdown, which looks like a possession. The Weeknd's first video for this album is for the song Heartless, and it's less horror and more fear and loathing in Las Vegas, as he licks a toad and proceeds to hallucinate and party on. But things go quickly wrong, and red lights in a quick shot of the devil precede us discovering that The Weeknd has blood pouring out his face in his next video for Blinding Lights. A fun fact for any fans of American Horror Story is that this video is partially shot in the Cicada restaurant in LA. the same location used for the lobby of the Hotel Cortez in American Horror Story Hotel. Next, he released a short film for the album in which he is pulled along the subway floor by an invisible force. His video for In Your Eyes picks up from here, where we enter an elevator with a butcher knife wielding The Weeknd. This video is like something out of an 80s slasher film. The now blood-splattered woman from the elevator is running for her life, and The Weeknd, framed in similar shots to Halloween's Michael Myers, is chasing her. Fast-paced editing takes us into a club, and then leaving the club, the clever woman grabs an axe on her way out, signalling, in case anyone doubted before, her likely status as a final girl. The Weeknd himself has obviously not picked up on this as he continues to pursue her into the boiler room. How very Freddy Krueger of him. She decapitates him and picks up his head as a trophy, like Medusa with Perseus. Silhouetted against the sunset, she finally picks up the axe and spins around with it. A clear reference to the end scene of the Texas Chainsaw Massacre. Too Late follows up the decapitating narrative as two post-plastic surgery bandaged up women stumble upon the Weeknd's severed head and become disturbingly obsessed with him. In outfits that would make Patrick Bateman proud, a gory scene occurs where they decapitate a man to sew the Weeknd's head onto his body. The story concludes in the Save Your Tears music video, where a fresh post-plastic surgery The Weeknd dances around with a gun in Joker fashion before pulling the trigger and letting out a flurry of confetti. During this time, The Weeknd also did an iconic Super Bowl halftime show which got compared by many to Jordan Peele's Us. The Weeknd's latest album, Dawn FM, sees the artist leaving the blood-soaked bright lights of After Hours for what has been described as a sort of purgatory. A purgatory where there's radio, hosted by a mysterious entity, voiced by none other than Jim Carrey, of course. So yes, it seems the Grinch may finally be coming to Halloween Horror Nights, sort of. So far, The Weeknd has only released 4 music videos for this album. The album itself is presented like a radio show, hosted by Jim Carrey, who opens the album by welcoming us to purgatory. This sets up the otherworldly, ominous tone of the album, so after the neon-lit darkness of After Hours comes the dawn. In the first video for the lead single of this album, Take My Breath, The Weeknd dances with a woman in a club and is eventually strangled by her braids. The video ends with him regaining his breath, leading narratively onto the second video. The second music video released for this album was for the song Sacrifice, and features, you guessed it, a sacrifice. The Weeknd, having regained his breath, continues to party in the same club featured in the Take My Breath Away music video, before he is taken captive by a black-cloaked ensemble. The group put The Weeknd on a circular device and perform a dance around him. The Weeknd begins to accept his fate, and a red-cloaked person emerges from the crowd, revealing her identity to be that of a beautiful woman. As she seduces him, she transforms into a corpse, reminiscent of the woman in Room 237 in Stanley Kubrick's The Shining. We then see The Weeknd chained to a microphone and painfully drained of his essence or soul, which exits his body as a beam of light. He is then freed from the microphone and shriveled in a similar way to the woman. The music video for Gasoline begins with an aged The Weeknd, presumably the outcome of the sacrifice. The very first shot we see is of ants crawling across a hearing aid in his ear, imagery that certainly belongs in a horror film. He drives down a road, struggling to find signal on his radio, while flies swarm his hearing aid. This distraction causes him to crash his car, and as he exits the wreckage, the song finally plays on the radio. Bugs crawl along the pavement, and the sky becomes filled with lightning. The elderly The Weeknd wanders his way into a dark club. An arm reaches through the floor, reminiscent of the iconic Evil Dead poster. As he parties, he transforms back into his younger self. Other guests switch between beautiful human faces to disfigured demon-like creatures. One of the creatures appears to feed on a woman, and a plant sprouts out the wall. In the club, he then comes face to face with his older self. Hands burst out from the ground and grab at the elder character, all while the youthful version manically smiles and laughs. The younger The Weeknd then brutally beats up his older self. His latest video for his song Out of Time features Squid Game star Ho Yeon Chung, and film icon and album feature, Jim Carrey. Inspired by Sofia Coppola's Lost in Translation, The Weeknd sings karaoke under blue hazy lights as he has fun with the beautiful Ho Young Chung. They run around a hotel before things start to get a bit eerie. The Weeknd looks behind him as he walks down a hotel hallway and it seems someone is following them. Suddenly, we are in a surgical room and the doors open out into the hotel, where the duo are still dancing. We see a champagne bucket overflowing with what looks like blood, and a shot of The Weeknd smashing a mirror. It seems things have not been as joyous as they have seemed. The two dance and spin, with The Weeknd's face suddenly aging before returning to normal. We see a shot of hands forcing the elevator open, then the same hands grabbing The Weeknd's shoulder. Bright white lights fill the frame and the scene becomes a hospital surgery room. The Weeknd's eyes open and he sees his aged hands. Playing a surgeon, Jim Carrey seems to be studying his body and places a mask over The Weeknd's face. The point of view shot we get here is reminiscent of so many slasher films where we reside in the mask with the killer. Knowing The Weeknd as we now do, it seems likely to suggest that he will pick the story up from here in another video, where I'm sure things will just get weirder and more horrific. As you now know, there's more than enough terrifying content within The Weeknd's music videos, even just focusing on his latest album, Dawn FM, which Universal's creative team will be able to pull from to build a horrific house this year. Hopefully this video has convinced you to be excited for The Weeknd's house at Halloween Horror Nights. Or if you were already excited, hopefully you've learned something new. Perhaps I've made you a fan, or if you're already a fan, I've made you a bigger fan of The Weeknd, and you're now going to endlessly read fan theories about his videos online. I promise I've only scratched the surface of these and there's tons more out there to learn. Personally, I can't wait to see how this idea is executed and I hope we get some cool HHNXO merchandise. No matter what, there's no denying what a huge draw to the event this house will be. Thank you for watching. Let me know what you think we'll see from The Weeknd at Halloween Horror Nights. Please like, subscribe, and check out my social media channels and website, all linked below.